Hello, analytics funners. Welcome to Analytics Fun. We are solving the Tableau official sample paper, which is given in the Tableau official desktop examination guide. Analytics funners, we are making the tutorial of different analytical technologies such as Tableau, Python, Alteryx, R, SAS, SQL, VBA, and Excel. So if you are interested in any of them, subscribe our channel to get instant notification in your feed. So this is the Tableau desktop specialist examination guide, which is given on this particular link. You have this link in the description section also. I'm scrolling down to the sample question section, and the question number 6 is a hands-on question using the stock 2010 to 2013 table. So there is a data set given which can be downloaded from this particular link. You can download the data set, and the download has completed. You can like view the data set here. The data set is opening. We have this data set here.
Before solving any question, understanding of data set is very important. So we have this stock price 2010 to 2013 table. Let us see what column we have. We have close, company name, date, high, low, number of records, open and volume. So we have like different companies and different dates. Let's see what company we have. We have three companies, Amazon, Apple and Biogen. And we have different date, starting from 4th January 2010 to 31st December 2013. So like we have 4 years, basically 2010, 2011, 2012 and 2013. And for every company and for every date, we have 5 key metrics here, which are close, high, low, open and volume. So if you have a basic understanding of stock market, you must be knowing that stock market opens at 9:30 a.m. in the morning. The price at 9:30 is the opening price, which is in column G. And the stock market generally closes at 3:30 p.m. in the evening. The price at 3:30 p.m. is given in column A, which is close. And between these two time period, what was the highest price of the stock, which is given in D column? And similarly, what was the lowest price in this period from 9:30 to 3:30 p.m. on 4th January? It is given in E column. And in H column, we have how many stocks per sale or purchased on this particular date, that is 4th January. The number of stocks are given as in the volume column, which is column H.
I have opened Tableau on my system. So let us load this data file. Let's go to Microsoft Excel. In the download, we have this data set, TDS sample data. And we have like three sheets here, flights, stock 2010 to 2013, stock 2014. For solving question number 6, we need stock 2010 to 2013 data set. So we'll drag this sheet in the drag sheet area. And in the preview pane, we can see this data set. We have closing price, company, date, high, low, open and volume as per our discussion earlier. Now let's move to the sheet area. So Tableau has classified all the fields in dimensions and measure. In dimensions, we have categorical fields such as string, company name, date is also a categorical field. And in measure, we have closing, high, low, open, volume. They are quantitative fields. So we know that the basic difference between the dimension and measure is that dimensions contain categorical data, string data, any kind of textual data, date data, while measure contain any kind of numerical data. Since dimension contain textual data, so no arithmetical operation can be applied on dimension, while arithmetical operations such as plus, minus, sum, division, average can be applied on measure because measures are numeric data. Before solving any hands-on question, we need to keep in mind three key mantras to solve any hands-on question. First mantra or first principle is that you need to identify the field or column required. So in a data set, you may get 10-12 columns, but not all columns or fields are necessary to solve that particular question. So you need to identify those particular field or columns. Second principle is reduction principle or using filter. So if you identify say 4 or 5 field, then you can reduce those fields to 2 or 1 by putting other fields in the filter area. So we'll see that in the question when we'll solve that question. And the principle number 3 or the mantra number 3, you have to identify the type of chart. So in Tableau, we have like 24 basic chart and there are a lot of advanced chart also. such as Gantt chart, Pareto chart, and donut chart, and various other chart, but you do not need to create any type of fancy chart in the examination. You can solve the question using these four types of chart which are given here: text table, line chart, map chart, and bar chart. And same answer can be derived from more than one chart type. So it can be possible that you have derived the answer from the text table, but your friend has arrived at the same answer using a line chart. So we'll tell you the scenario where to use like text table, line chart, map chart, or bar chart when we'll practice the question. Let's begin our question, question number 6. So the question is, using the stocks 2010 to 2013 table, create a chart to see the monthly change in volume of stock beginning of 2010 to the end of 2013. Which two consecutive months saw the least fluctuation in volume increase or decrease? So the fluctuation question are very favorite in Tableau, and as per our mantra, we should like first identify the field. So let us identify the field. So principle number one is identify a field. So which fields are required in this particular question? So we have which two consecutive months. How will we get the month? Because we have date field in our question, in our data set. So we need one date field. Second, saw the least fluctuation in volume increase or decrease. So we need a volume column as well. So we need only two fields, date and volume. Principle number two, that reduce the field. Reduction is all not necessary for every question, since in this particular question we are not asked about any particular year or any particular company, so reduction is not possible, and like you can directly go with these two fields. Now moving, to the principle number three, which is identify type of chart. Since this is a fluctuation question and the question is asking about, so moving to principle number three, which is to identify type of chart. So moving to principle number three, which is identification of type of charts. So basically this question is a fluctuation question, which is asking that least fluctuation in volume increase or decrease. Fluctuation question are very favorite for in Tableau desktop examination. So whenever there is a least fluctuation question, that is the fluctuation is very less, so you need to see a flat line on your chart, a flat line. Whenever the question is asking about highest fluctuation, so you need to see a spike, because spike give you a highest fluctuation. So whenever there is least fluctuation, so you need to identify a flat line on your chart. Suppose this is your chart and you have something like this trend, and there is a flat line, and then the chart goes like this. So you need to identify a flat line on your chart like this. So this will be least fluctuation. And when the question is about highest fluctuation, and suppose that your chart is like this, something like this, and then you get a peak, and then the chart is like again like this. So for maximum fluctuation question, you need to identify a sudden spike in the question. So this is the highest fluctuation, H, and this is the lowest fluctuation or the least fluctuation. So the principle number three, the type of chart will be line chart, because this is a fluctuation question. Now let us go back to Tableau and solve our question. And we have principle number one, we need date and volume. So date and volume, will select the date and will hold the control key, then select volume. We'll go to show me and will create a continuous line chart as we have discussed. So we have volume on the y-axis and year on the x-axis. Please note that you have date field in the dataset. It automatically convert the date into year. And here is a plus icon which is known as hierarchy. So basically when we click on it, it changes to quarter, and we again like click on it, it changes to month. So now we have volume on the y-axis and month on the x-axis, and when we like hover over it, we'll get the month and the volume at that particular month. So the question is asking which two consecutive months saw the least fluctuation in volume increase or decrease So we'll have to look at the flat line here. So where is the flat line? The flat line is here, which is March 2012 and April 2012. Hence, the correct answer of this question is March 2012 to April 2012. Analytics funners, we hope that you have enjoyed this video. Support us by clicking on thumbs up icon and subscribe our channel for more such updates. Thank you, Analytics funner. See you in the next one.